Hi guys, and welcome to my channel. My name is Taylor, and on this channel I talk about health, spirituality, law of attraction, biohacking, nutrition, and so much more. So I'm super excited to jump into this video because I'm talking about the importance of mind-body connection, and as you can tell by the title, we're going to be talking about changing your appearance and your health with thought alone. And I know this can seem kind of woo, and like, you guys probably are like, you can't change the way you look and you can't change your health just by thinking, but you really can. And I'm here to prove you wrong because I'm gonna share with you my story and also ways that I was able to implement this into my life and make it work for me. So to give you guys a little bit of a background with my story, I got acne when I was in elementary school. I started my period at a very young age and I struggled with acne for most of my life. And I remember being put on birth control in sixth grade and having to deal with all that at such a young age, and that changed a lot for me. Being on birth control made me gain weight a lot. My skin wasn't really able to completely heal, so I really went through a rough journey with that, and I struggled with that for a very long time, and it really affected me mentally and physically. My thoughts, everything about myself, I would look at myself in the mirror and I completely hated what I saw. I was not always the smallest person. I had acne, obviously. I had acne that covered my chest and my back and my face. And although maybe if you haven't struggled with acne, it really affects your mental health in the worst way possible. It got to a point where I didn't even want to turn on the light in the bathroom when I'd go to the bathroom, or just in my room in general, I wouldn't want to look at myself in the mirror. And that's how bad it was. And I'm sure a lot of you guys can relate with that, not liking exactly what you see in the mirror and really not being happy with yourself physically and mentally. So fast forward to 2 years ago, I was introduced to the law of attraction and it really changed my way of thinking. I started learning about it through YouTube. I was watching Leora Alexandra and she really taught me a lot about it, and I was starting to implement it into my life and I really saw big changes. I wasn't really using it for anything physical but more on the external realm, which is like a car, a house, a boyfriend, anything like that. That's really where we usually start off. So within that first year of learning about the law of attraction, I would use it within my job. So at the time, I wasn't very happy with where I was in my career life, and I'm sure you guys could watch back to previous videos and I kind of talk more about that, but I would take that energy and I would bring it into my workspace, because I remember going into work being really unhappy a lot, and I noticed that when I would remember to use the law of attraction in the workspace, it really worked for me. I remember walking out with more money. I actually got 2 raises that year, which is really crazy. I hadn't gotten a raise that whole time of working at my job. It was insane and I was so grateful for that. And I remember just thinking like, wow, I'm literally manifesting more abundance in my life, and it was amazing. So towards the tail end of 2019 and early 2020, my life changed completely. And again, I'm not gonna go into this a lot, you guys can watch my previous videos, but I basically lost my job and I ended up starting on a program for holistic health, and I became a holistic health coach through IIN. So late 2019 and early 2020, I still kind of suffered with acne here and there, and I had an issue with my weight. My weight was always fluctuating and I really wasn't the smallest person, and I really just wasn't happy with the way I looked. But I also don't think that eating french fries from my work almost every day helped at all. And if you guys don't know, I worked at Hooters for 7 years and I literally would eat the fries almost every day. So yeah, I know that that didn't help, but I know that my mind and my thoughts really changed that exponentially. But I feel that I look a lot different, and even my boyfriend agrees. My stomach has changed its shape and it's really crazy how different it looked a while back. My skin has gotten so much better, and I know that that really boils down to the way that I have been thinking and how I've been seeing myself. And honestly, my whole body shape has changed a lot. And I really owe most of that to my thoughts and the way that I was thinking. So now I know you're probably wondering, like, how did you do this? How did all this happen? And I'm going to tell you three simple ways that you can really change your life and implement all this into your life too. So the first thing that I started adding into my life that really changed everything for me was meditation. And I know I've talked about this in my previous videos, but meditation has really changed my life a lot. And I don't think we give ourselves enough time to really be quiet within ourselves and really hear ourselves think. And I think it's so important. So what I would do, and I still do, is I meditate right when I wake up. And I find that right when you wake up, it's the best time because it kind of sets the tone for the day. And instead of checking your phone and getting up to do things or start work, you literally get up, maybe stretch a little bit, make sure you're awake, and you sit up and you meditate. And I literally do this right in my bed. I don't have to get out of bed to do this. You can, but I just find that I'm comfortable in my bed and I prop the pillows up and I literally just sit there and I meditate. In a powerful way that you can really change the way you look, change the way you feel, is visualization. So visualizing while you're meditating is so powerful. So while you're meditating, you can take a few minutes to kind of just settle in your mind and be silent, or if you're listening to music or different frequencies, it doesn't matter. Just kind of sit in silence for a little bit. And then while you're in that deep meditation, you can start visualizing the person that you want to become. So you'll ask yourself, how does this person look? How do you feel? How are you acting? How are you living? Really feel into each of those and try to paint a picture in your mind of what that looks like exactly for you. So in my case, like if you're struggling with acne, you can close your eyes and visualize yourself with clear, beautiful, smooth skin. How will it feel when you finally have that beautiful skin? How are you acting? How are you living? Really ask yourself those questions and feel into all of them. I think we're so used to looking at ourselves and visualizing ourselves in a bad way, especially if we're looking at ourselves in the mirror. And I know I've struggled with that for a long time. And I remember looking at myself and not liking what I see, but also throughout the day in my mind thinking, oh my gosh, people are looking at my skin is so broken out right now, my weight, my clothes don't fit me right. You're constantly painting this negative picture in your mind about how you look, and also those thoughts can't make you feel good either. So really changing the way you see yourself can really change your life and change the way you see yourself completely. And the next one is affirmations. And affirmations are so powerful, and I don't think that a lot of people do them because it kind of feels weird doing affirmations with yourself, because it's awkward sometimes, like saying like, I am beautiful, I am abundant, I am this. It can feel ingenuine, and I know because I remember when I first started doing them, it felt kind of weird. But for me, what has helped me is listening to affirmations on YouTube or through somebody that you enjoy listening to, and really listening to those affirmations and either saying them out loud, and of course speaking your truth and saying those words out loud obviously creates more energy around that. So speaking is very powerful, but you can also just listen to it and train your mind around that. So for me, I wake up, I like to get ready in the morning, and while I'm getting ready, looking at myself in the mirror, I'm saying those affirmations and I'm saying them out loud. And what I like to say to my skin is, you are healing and you are beautiful. And constantly repeating that in the mirror, it really changes the way that you see yourself. And you can do that whatever you wish to create in your life. So like I said, I know a lot of us are busy and sometimes we don't have time to look at ourselves in the mirror and say, we are beautiful, we are this, we are that. So instead, having an affirmations playlist playing in the background and just programming your subconscious mind, and that alone can really do so many amazing things for your body and for your health. Constant repetition and constant affirmations really will help you create that in your life. And honestly, I think affirmations are the most important one out of all of these, and I swear by these, and I know that you can really change your health and the way you look with affirmations alone. So please get started with affirmations. I promise you will notice a difference in your mental health, your physical health, all aspects of your life. So my third thing is kind of tying into affirmations in a way, but it's listening to positive or just like high vibe music. This really changes your energy, but not just listening to high vibe music or positive music, but also dancing. And I'm sure you guys are probably like, Taylor, I'm not gonna dance by myself in my room. Like, that's just way too weird. And honestly, I can understand that, because when I first started doing this, I felt so weird doing that in my room, so I completely understand. But as time went on, I really noticed a huge difference in the way my day went, but also the way my thought process was for the rest of the day. Even this morning, for example, I was getting so irritated trying to set up this whole thing right now, because I got a new ring light and it took me so long to try to figure out how to set it up, and I still wasn't able to set it up, and it really frustrated the crap out of me. So instead of getting in a bad mood and not recording, I made some cacao and I played some good music, and I literally danced in my kitchen while my cacao was being made, and it really changed my whole way of being. I literally went from not wanting to record anymore, not wanting to do anything at all, to wanting to record, to being super inspired to make this video. And yeah, I really promise that this can absolutely change your way of being. And when you're in this flow state and just like feeling all this amazing energy, you're not focusing on things that you don't like about yourself. You're not focusing on the things that you don't have. You're not focusing on the person that you are not. You're literally being who you are, and you're totally happy with that. And if I could live like that for the rest of my life, I would. And I know that my health would totally benefit from that. But at least I know that this tool can really bring me back into that way of living. And I wanted to share a quote that I actually saw on Instagram the other day that really touched me, and it literally goes hand in hand with what I just said. So it is a quote from Gabrielle Roth, and it is, "In many shamanic societies, if you came to a medicine person complaining of being disheartened, dispirited, or depressed, they would ask you one of four questions. When did you stop dancing? When did you stop singing? When did you stop being enchanted by stories? When did you stop being comforted by the sweet territory of silence?" And I love this quote, especially the first two parts, because I think that's where we should be in the beginning stages of this, and asking yourself, when did you stop dancing? When did you stop singing? When did you stop having fun? And I think a lot of us can say that you don't have fun as an adult, but you literally can. Life is meant to be enjoyed. We weren't put on earth to be these serious beings and just working at a job and living a normal life. We were meant to be put here on earth to live fully, to really feel the full human experience, to have the opportunity of raising your vibration and experiencing everything life has to offer. I just wanted to share that quote with you guys because I loved it. So you're probably wondering, how do they change your health and change your appearance? Your body will respond to this new way of thinking, being, and feeling, and it's not used to that. So to kind of go into a more scientific definition of this, if you look into epigenetics, you are able to turn your genes on and off. You can't change your genes, but you can turn good genes on and bad genes off. And you are able to do that with your thoughts alone. And to kind of sum it up in simple terms, your body isn't used to looking at yourself in the mirror and loving what you see. Your body isn't used to you talking to yourself in a certain way that actually is positive. Your body isn't used to moving in a way. If you're dancing and listening to music, your body isn't used to movement and the feelings of happiness. It's a completely new way of being, and your body will slowly adapt to that, and your good genes will turn on, which means that your appearance will start to change, and your body will change in a way that you want it to look or feel. And I can get super scientific with you guys, but I just want to keep this clean and simple. And if you guys want more information on this, look up Dr. Joe Dispenza. He has written so many amazing books. He's been on so many different podcasts, and he is just an amazing human being that has changed lives all over the world. And to kind of give you some insight of what he does, he has hosted events that are focused around changing the way you think and the way you view yourself. And to kind of paint a picture, he has literally seen blind people see. He has seen people with cancer completely healed by changing their thoughts alone. So this is real, guys. This is science. You are completely capable of changing your appearance, changing your health, changing your life through the power of positive thinking. You can literally change your entire life with your mind. And I think that's incredible. I think that we all need to awaken to that magic that's within us, because we all have it. We're all capable of creating the life that we've always wanted. I think this is something that should be taught in schools, because this is so important, and we can all benefit from this, guys. Like, we can literally change our entire life. So yeah, guys, if you want more information on that, I recommend looking up Dr. Joe Dispenza. He's on Instagram. He's on multiple different platforms. You can listen to him on podcasts. His books are amazing. And you can also message me and we can go deep into this, because I love talking about it and I would love to chat more about this whole topic with you. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and were able to get something out of it. And please subscribe to my channel and like this video if you feel called to. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next video.